I'm sure that you see case openings like this.
Oh, I saw it. I saw it, dude.
Oh my god! 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 Oh my god!
So when I try, it ended up something like that.
That was another thing about.
Fuck!
So I decided to create custom roulette application that only provide positive outcomes. Hello everyone, this is Mr. Random Generator. In this video, I will be making a GitHub Roulette. So, to begin with, we first need to design which consists of heading, rolling roulette stuff, random repo, random user, and go button to start it all. So, let's get started.
Thank you.
Now I finished the application in Unity and build it. As you can see, we have an exe file, so let's run that. As you can see, we now have created our application, which should give us the random repositories. So let's get started. We hit the go button. It takes actually a few seconds to fetch all users from the GitHub API, and we should see users listed in a minute. There we go. Now it should start rolling. And we get Xenex, and we get GeoClueShare repository from him. And the cool thing is that that repository address is actually copied on our clipboard. So we just Alt F4 to close our application and see what that repository actually is. So we go there and GeoClueShare. So Android application. Oh, cool, it's a GPS based application. I think it shares location and stuff like that. So as you can see, we can discover multiple repositories by using the roulette that I have created. It's all cool and all, but how that thing actually works. So now let's look at it. So here's the main logic of the application, but many of guys requested that my code will be too basically small, so let's make it massive. And there we go. So first we define some variables, which we'll be looking at in a second. And in our start function, so we just create the images to false. We don't want to see them loaded one by one. So it basically loads when every image finished loading its displays. So if we move on to the getRandom function, which is called when we press the go button, we basically make some simple operations like setting the kinematic to true and stuff like that, because as you can imagine, if we push go multiple times, it should support that. So these stuff basically handle that. And after that, the important thing is that we start our coroutine, which calls the getUsers, i.e. enumerator. So in that enumerator, what we do is create a web request to our GitHub API. And we tell GitHub to bring the users after 2020. And the reason I do that is because I don't want to overload the GitHub with basically BS requests. So, because I love GitHub. So, anyway, after we just created our request, we send it. But the one important thing to mention that is that we need to create objects basically to basically just map the returned JSON object, like I fetched here, to the actual variables so we can use them later on. So in the end of the code, as you can see, I have a massive object that creates all properties of repos and users. So I use them. And let's look at how I use them. So again, we just go here. We created an user list, which is a variable defined at top. And I basically map it. Same thing goes for the repos. I just fetch them randomly and assign them. And yeah, basically I just handle some edge cases here and there. It's not a big deal. And after that, I pick a random repo and then get random repos and stuff like that. Actually, this is not the thing I want to go too detailed on that, because it's have minor stuff which are not really important. So I will provide link in the description to a repository which is a repository inside a repository, I know. And you can just clone the code and try it for yourself and see if you can even improve it. So anyway, hope you like this project. Thank you for watching. If you like this, please make sure to hit like button and consider subscribing. See you next time. Take care.